And welcome to the prelim specific discussion of the Hindu newspaper. Today we shall be discussing the news relevant for prelims in the newspaper of the 1st of March. So coming to the first article, which is important. Now here the Election Commission allows 11 documents to prove voters' identity. Now these kind of questions become important for prelims because they also represent a practical aspect of voting. The UPSC is going to expect that candidates are going to vote. And in that context, this is some piece of practical information. So such question can be framed. A question on elections is something that is going to be expected. So even the aspects related to election in the polity paper is something that you should prepare for prelims. That is something you should know. Now, the documents that are accepted are passport, a driving license, a service identity card of the central and state government, public sector undertakings and public limited companies, bank or post office passbooks carrying photographs of voters, PAN cards, smart cards issued under the National Population Register, the MNREGA job card and health insurance smart card. So these are the list of documents that are accepted. Even pension documents with photograph, official identity cards issued to the legislators and Aadhaar card have also been included. And for the overseas electors, what is required is their original passport only for identification. So that is something that you should know. What is important is that the photo voter slip will not be accepted. So the photo voter slip is what is not accepted. Rest, any identity document which has a photograph attached is something that will be accepted to prove the identity of the voter. So this is something that can be asked and this becomes important for us. Next news is related to the five nations signing the declaration, and this is known as the New Delhi Declaration. This declaration is what has been signed vis-a-vis the status of the rhinos in the Asian continent. So this is something that you should know. It is New Delhi Declaration. Now, this declaration has been signed by five countries, that is India, Bhutan, Indonesia, Malaysia, and Nepal. And as per this declaration, a transboundary collaboration is what has been held between India, Nepal, and Bhutan to secure the future of Asian rhino species. Now, what is happening is that this particular region of India, Nepal, and Bhutan, the northeastern part of India, that is in Assam, now this was one corridor for the rhinos, but what was happening is that the rhinos were not staying exclusively in a country, so they were moving through a passage which was transgressing through these other countries, that is Nepal and Bhutan also. But what was happening was that the laws were different in each country, so this was somehow impacting the mobility of the rhinos and their well-being. So for the better protection, a transboundary collaboration is what is going to be done, and a same set of rules is what is going to be implied in all the protected areas across India, Nepal, and Bhutan in this particular region for the comfortable movement of the rhinos. So that is something that becomes important. The Manas National Park as well as the Kaziranga National Park of India, which are both in Assam, become important in this regard. Also, you should know that this is the second meeting of the Asian Rhino Range states. These states are these five countries, and these five countries are important because the rhino population is exclusive to these five countries in Asia. Also, there are three Asian rhino species. One is the one-horned rhino. This is the rhino which is found in the Kaziranga National Park, and the others are Javan and the Sumatran rhino. Now, these are largely threatened and there is very few is the count what is left of these rhinos. So an example, a model of Kaziranga National Park is what is going to be emulated in Java as well as in Sumatra to protect these rhinos. So that is what becomes important for us. These five countries are what are important. These are exclusively found in India is what is important. Assam's and Assam's national parks is what becomes important in this regard. So this is something that you should know for prelims. Next, what is important is this small news on Arctic Ocean. Now, what is happening is that often there is news on the Arctic region, and Arctic region has always been a favorite of UPSC for prelims. So this gives us an opportunity to discuss about the geography of this particular region. So that is something that we should do. Now, basically, you should know that this is surrounded by four countries. One is Canada, second is the US, third is Russia, and then there is Greenland, which is a part of Denmark. Also, what becomes important are the sea. The Bering Sea is important, the Shukshi Sea is what is important. You should see this particular diagram and you should at least once analyze all these particular important areas that are there, so that if a question is what comes, then it can be easily identified. And that is what is going to be the relevance of discussing this issue, though the topic is that by the year 2040, Arctic summers may turn ice free. This is largely because of climate change that is happening. So that is what is important for prelims. Please see this diagram once again. It is going to be an important one. So that's all for today's discussion vis-a-vis prelims. Thank you all for watching the video.